Hello there guys, welcome to my channel Dream to Animate. In the last video I have discussed about the tools and their uses. Now I will talk about timeline, layers and frames. These are important if you learn the software Adobe Flash and also want to make some basic animation. So watch this video till end. If you like this video then hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe this channel. Move on to the video, let's get started. Frame to animate. So first I will talk about the timeline. You can see this at the bottom of the software. At the left side you can see layer. Now some of you know what is layer but some of you don't. So who don't know what a layer is, I want to talk about it for them. Here layer describes the different levels to place any object. When you will animate something, you have to place an object on the top layer if you want to show it in front of other objects. As an example, I am creating two objects on two different layers. At the bottom left corner, you will see an icon which says new layer. If you click on it, it will create a new layer. And now, if you want to rename it, you can rename it by double clicking here. It is a very good habit to rename the layer because when you do some complex animation and then things get messy and it might confuse you. So I will suggest you make it as clean as possible by naming proper way. Now what I'm going to do is I'm creating a rectangular here on layer 2, so I rename it as a rectangular. Hit enter. So now I'm making a rectangular here. So this is a red rectangular and now I'm renaming the layer 1 as circle because I'm placing a circle on this layer. So now I'm making a circle. I would like to give it a nice blue color. So this is now blue color. Now you can see the rectangular layer is on the top. So the rectangular is showing in front of the circle. If you want to make the circle on the top of rectangle, you have to just click the circle layer and drag it to the top of rectangle. Now you can see the circle is came forward and the rectangle is in the behind. So that is what actually a layer does. Now here is two more icons you can see, which is a new folder and another one is delete. Folder help you to arrange the layer by putting some kind of layer in a folder, and delete layer is for deleting a layer. So if I want to delete the circle layer here, I will just click on the circle layer and then click on the delete button and you can see the circle has deleted. Now you can see a pencil icon beside the layer name here. So it indicates you can draw on this layer or not. Beside this you can see two dots and also there is two icons above of these two dots. This is for show or hide all layers. What it actually do is, if you want to hide this object, so you have to just click here and you can see the object is hidden now. It is not deleted, it is just hidden. If you click here again, you can see the object, it is here. And to if you click on this icon, it will hide all the layers you are creating here. So to hide all the layers, just click here and you'll see all the layers has hidden. And beside that you can see a lock icon what it does is it actually lock your object. So if you don't want to move this object accidentally, just click here and now you can see you can't move it. But if you unlock this, and then you can move it. And after locking it, you can't move it. So this is what these two icons does. Beside that, you can see a box filled with color. If you click here, then whatever object you place here, those objects fill color will be hidden. You can only see the outline. This is not a stroke line, it is just an outline to make you understand the shape of the object and where it is actually. It is helpful to see if there is any object behind this object. If I create a circle here again, and now if I am selecting the circle and moving it completely and making it some smaller so that it completely covered by this rectangle. Now you can see, you can't see the circle here. So to see the circle, either you have to hide the rectangle layer, then you can see, or you just click here to see the object, and also you can modify it like this. So why do you need this when you have the hide layer option? It is useful to make you understand where the top layer's object is, and you can modify the bottom layer object according to this. You can't see anything when you click on the hide layer option. And now I will talk about this long thing. So this is actually our frames. So what is frame? Frames are like a single page where you draw one or more objects. So do you remember I have told you to make an animation, you need to draw a couple of images. So every image is called a frame. And these little boxes here, you can see, it hold one drawing. So here we have three kind of frames. First, keyframe. Keyframe is the frame where you can modify your drawing or you can draw anything. Second, blank keyframe. Blank keyframe means in that frame there is no drawing or no object. Third is holding frame, or simply frame that holds a drawing. For example, I will draw a rectangle. And now if you see here, you will see a box with a circle. The circle is empty from inside. That means here is no drawing, which makes it a blank keyframe. As soon as I draw the rectangle here, I'm drawing the rectangle, and now you can see the circle has filled, which makes it a keyframe. And now this is filled mean there is a drawing, which is this rectangle here. Now you can't see this type of box on other boxes like this because I did not insert frames. So let's say I want frames up to 100. So I will just click on the 100 number here and then go to insert, timeline, and frames. You can see frames. Now there is frame from 1 to 100. Now you can see this line, red line with a box on the top. This is your cursor, and you can see this cursor is movable from 1 to 100 like this, but not moving after 100 because there is no frame after 100. So I'm just adding more frame up to 150, and to do that I'm using shortcut, which is F5. If you click F5, you can see the frames have inserted. And now you can see the cursor is moving up to 150. 1 to 150 now. Now, I told you there is 3 types of frame. So these frames from 2 to 150, this is called holding frames or simply frames. That means you can't modify your drawing. If you modify your drawing here, it will modify all the frames. To modify only that frame, you have to insert a keyframe on that frame. Let's say you want to modify on the 20 number of frame. So I will select the 20 number of frame, and here you can see when you click on 20, it's showing that you are on 20 number frame. So this indicates where you actually are. If you select 40 number frames, now you can see it shows 40. That indicates the current frame where actually you are. So I want to modify on 20 number. So what I'm doing is I'm inserting a keyframe at 20 number. So to do that, I will again go to insert, timeline, and keyframe. Now you can see it has a keyframe now, and this is the difference between a normal frame, I mean the holding frame, and keyframe. When you enter a keyframe, you will see this small circle here, but in the holding frame there is no circle. So to modify it, I just drag this to here, and now you can see it moving. To make the movement smooth, I'm just select the 10 number frame and inserting a keyframe here, and now I'm using the shortcut, which is F6. If I click F6, it insert a keyframe here. So now what I'm going to do is I'm moving this object little bit more so that it actually looks like this object is middle of number 1 and number 20, and now you can see it is smooth. To make it more smooth, insert a keyframe on 5 and move it little bit, and also insert a keyframe on the 15 and move it little bit here. So now if you can see, the movement is become more smooth. So this is keyframe. And if you talk about the blank keyframe, that is F7, and if you click here and if you press F7, you can see there is nothing, because I'm enter a blank keyframe, which means it has nothing on this frame. You can also do that by deleting the object. Like if I take a keyframe here and then I delete the object, then you can see it became an empty keyframe or blank keyframe. Now what we see in the bottom here, for those I will make another video. This is it for now. Try to make simple animation by inserting keyframe, holding frames, and blank keyframes. If you like this video, please like it by clicking the like button and subscribe this channel for latest update. And if you have any question, then comment below. Also, you can contact me on Facebook and Twitter. Link is in the description. This is Krishna, and I'm signing out. See you later.